so what you're making is king turnip. There's some mushrooms. So what you're going to need is your king turnip, and you're going to slice these into some nice sized pieces. You want them to be about a half inch thick. I am trying to film and cut, so don't do that, but cut them into about a half inch thickness, and they should look something like this. They don't have to look perfect. Yeah, so about a half an inch to an inch thick, and you'll have a bunch of these. And then all you're gonna do is take some butter. I'm using some Miyoko butter. And what you're gonna do is season your butter. So I'm adding in some garlic powder, onion powder, and some oregano and parsley if you have some, and pepper. And you're just gonna mix that all together. And this is basically the base for your scallions or king turnip scallions. And you're just gonna place this in that butter, and the mushroom is gonna absorb it as it cooks, and it'll get nice and golden on the opposite side, as you can see. And the flavor is just all in there, and it's been marinating and cooking inside of this butter, so it has that flavor fully. And all you're gonna do is flip them after a couple of minutes. You're cooking this on medium high heat, so make sure to watch them as they cook. Yeah, you're just gonna let them cook until they're done on the opposite side. And I'm gonna toss in my tomatoes. And then you're just gonna toss in your cherry tomatoes. I cut them in half, and you're gonna let those saute with the mushrooms. Look at how pretty that looks. Okay, once they're done and your pasta is done, you're gonna make your pasta. So your pasta just consists of your pasta, your butter, and your spaghetti of choice, depending on what you're making. And you're gonna toss that inside of your butter mixture because you want it to be nice and flavorful. So toss it around. And then you're gonna add in your mushrooms and your tomatoes, and you're just gonna fold this into itself so it's all well incorporated. You can make more mushrooms, you can make more tomatoes. I didn't have a lot left, so I just made what I had, and this is what it looks like. And then we're gonna take this, look at how good that looks, and pour it inside of a bowl. You know, horrible presentation, whatever. It's gonna be in my stomach soon anyways. So yeah, drop the tomato. And this is what it looks like, guys. So now we're gonna make the cheese sauce. So you're gonna add in some parsley, fresh parsley. And I'm gonna add, I added in some walnut milk I made earlier. You can add in almond milk, add whatever you have. And I'm just taking a slice of Follow Your Heart cheese. I think that's Gouda, I don't remember, but it's one of the Follow Your Heart cheeses. And you're just gonna mix this all together, and you'll have like this sauce base. It's gonna be nice and creamy. And gradually just, you can add in more cheese if you want. And then you have this cheese sauce. Super simple, super easy, and it's packed with flavor. It's so yummy. And that is gonna be poured over the pasta. So yeah, that's the cheese sauce. Sorry, I can't record and cook at the same time. So yeah, this is this. Again, all of this is being recorded on my iPad, so it's a little crazy, but that's the cheese sauce on top of there. You can make more of it if you like. Make less of it, up to you. How good that looks. Yum. Alright, so that's all she wrote. The tomatoes, the mushrooms, the sauce, the everything looks delicious. Thanks for watching. Please make sure to like and subscribe.